Next up, we'll hear from one of the candidates for House 10, the mainly rural district that stretches along the Parks Highway north of Houston all the way to the Denali border. Democrat Patricia Faye-Brazel is with us tonight. Republican House 10 candidate David Eastman has declined Alaska Public Media's invitation to appear on running. Ms. Faye-Brazel, let's start with your opening statement, please.
Well, I am Patricia Faye-Brazel, and I'm originally from Vermont. I think a lot of people recognize me from the Bernie Sanders campaign. I was his designee for the state of Alaska and the National Platform Committee. I've been a community planner and a community organizer all of my life. I never intended to be a candidate. I've been asked to be a candidate before and refused. This year is different, and so I'm stepping up.
All right, so let's get to the questions. And how do you think the outcome of this election, the state and national election, will shape politics in Alaska?
Well, this year is very different. I've been going around, I've been talking to everybody in my district, and people are really dissatisfied with their government. They feel like their government is broken and they don't know how to fix it. They know we have a legislature that hasn't done anything in about 3 years to fix this oncoming budget crisis. We've seen it coming for a long time. And people want change, and they want real change. They don't want to just replace the old change with the same thing. They want something different.
Okay. How would you attempt to fix the budget crisis? Would you go with the long-term fiscal plan, or are you in favor of more cutting? How would you
It's going to be a combination of things, but I think before we do anything, we have to look at the cause of this deficit. We have a monolithic economy. We haven't done anything to diversify our economy and to localize and regionalize it. And we have an oil interest that doesn't pay its fair share. SB 21 knocked the oil net revenue tax down from 35% to 8%. That is our deficit right there. That's got to change. But it's not going to change until we get people who are elected to the legislature who are not paid for by those oil interests one way or another.
Would you advocate for a diversification of Alaska's economy? I mean, given the oil downturn has just...
I think in a very slow way it is doing that, but we need to support that more. And we need to support 21st century education, mm-hmm. because if we want a 21st century economy, we're going to have the technology and the people capable of that technology to run that.
Could you elaborate on that statement a little more? I mean, what are the challenges facing education in Alaska?
Well, one of the biggest challenges facing education is that it seems to be the first on the cutting block. You know, when we talk about the fiscal budget, we immediately talk about cuts. And when we talk about cuts, we immediately go to the large item, which is education, health care, and infrastructure. And it's ironic because those are the three things that are really a boon to the economy. If we don't have a good educational system, we're not going to have a good economy. If we don't have a good infrastructure system, we're going to lose our economy. And infrastructure is part of that economy.
So let's wrap that up. We have time for a couple of more questions. Speaking of cuts, would you take a look around your district, other than the budget, what is the top issue that needs to be fixed in your area?
You know, there's not a lot of economy in my area. But one of the things that I really notice is, you know, Alaska's an island for food. If the planes go down and the barges don't come, we have several days worth of food in the state. But in my district, we have all of these small self-sustaining farmers, and they're not completely self-sustaining, but maybe they have enough eggs that they feed their neighborhood. Maybe they grow enough chickens that there's meat for the neighborhood. We need to look at that local kind of sustainable agriculture on a small scale.
All right, well, it's time for your closing statement, Ms. Faye-Brazel.
Well, I think I would just like to say showing up is important. It counts. And campaigning is a job interview. And showing up is important. We have to be able to talk to people, and more importantly, we have to go out and listen to people. It's not just about as much as we put out and say what we think. It's about how much we listen to what people want and what their needs are. And I think that's very important. And what I can say about myself is that I will work for the public interest. I will work for the people. I will not work for large multinational corporation interests. I will work for what matters to Alaska.
That's House 10 Democratic candidate Patricia Faye-Brazel.